A Sydney surprise for this mother and daughter who hadn't seen each other in more than 6 months. Reunited as the country's two most populous states removed all remaining border restrictions for fully vaccinated travellers.
It's really nice. I'm sorry, it's just a bit overwhelming. I've got 5 babies to meet, so we're going to make our way to meet one now, and then I've got my niece who was born yesterday.
I'm happy she's home. This is what I've been waiting for.
So we're here for a family wedding that we didn't think we were going to make, so amazing.
I know, I just came from Melbourne. I haven't seen this one for 4 months. Yeah, Mr. Lim, you know, so it hasn't been the same.
Today's joyous reunion's made possible due to high vaccination coverage in both states.
80% of Australians aged over 16 will be double vaccinated today. We will pass through that mark today, and that will be another massive breakthrough.
Meanwhile, excitement also among those heading south to Melbourne.
I got my family there in Melbourne. Actually, my daughter in the university there. I'm working here in Sydney. I'm stuck here. The first time I got to go see him.
We've tried to go like 4 times and had trips cancelled, so it's a friend's 40th and I'm really excited.
Under the changes, New South Wales is now considered a green zone for Victoria's travel permit system. Quarantine and testing requirements have been scrapped for travellers heading to Victoria, including the unvaccinated. But unvaccinated Victorians are not allowed to enter New South Wales for recreation or a holiday. In a joint statement last night, Premiers Dominic Perrottet and Daniel Andrews said New South Wales and Victoria are normalising living with the virus. The statement also signalling a thawing in cross-border relations that were at times tense under former New South Wales Premier Gladys Berejiklian. The Sydney-Melbourne route was once the second busiest flight path in the world. Despite the COVID-induced turbulence, the air corridor between Australia's two largest cities remains among the top 10 frequently flown. Rochelle Harrison-Pless, SBS World News.